Hello. All right. Let's go to work. Son of a bitch. People of the YouTube, I'm back. I didn't post for a while because I was on vacation, and now vacation's over. It's my first day going back to work. And that I did record some stuff. Not a lot. I didn't go vlog crazy. Because it was my vacation. I went to Italy. Italy. It's the best. I saw a lot of cool stuff. Saw friends and family, then did some touristing. But really cool was going to Mandello di Lario, Lake Como, to the Moto Guzzi Museum and Factory. And it was a cool day. The Moto Guzzi Factory is in Mandello di Lario, Lake Como. It's up by the Alps. It's just absolutely beautiful. And I've never seen anything like it before. And we went up there for a few days, specifically just to visit the Moto Guzzi factory and museum, which the museum is only open 1 hour a day, Monday through Friday. And so it's a long way to go for 1 hour. And, you know, online and stuff, it's either just, oh, it's just a little museum. There's no, nothing special. It's just, you know, some old bikes. And then you get the people that are total, you know, Guzzi maniacs that, you know, it's Mecca. So I was hoping for something in between. Lake Como kind of looks like a wishbone, you know, and we were on one side of the lower left side of the wishbone, and the factory was on the other side. So we had to drive down to take a bus down to the train station, get the car, drive around the bottom of the lake, through this kind of industrial area, and finally to the plant. And you get there, and it's just this little town, nothing going on a Monday, and the big red Moto Guzzi door, you know? And so we waited and walked around and found the Agostini shop, the custom exhausts and stuff for Moto Guzzis. And then, promptly, at 3 p.m., it's a weird hour to open a museum, 3 p.m., with a scattering of other like-minded Guzzi fanatics, maybe 10 or 15 people, the door opens, and it starts to slide open, and it was like Willy Wonka. It was like going to the chocolate factory, and you've got the golden ticket, and the door is opening, and I've got a golden ticket, because I've got a golden ticket, because I've got a golden ticket, and then the door just kind of stops, because they don't need to open it the entire way, because why? And so they go in, and this, like, really smooth-looking security guard makes you sign in, and then the tour begins. And the tour was led by this guy named Walter. Walter! An Italian, very Italian name, Walter. And he had worked at the factory for about 30-some years, and he didn't speak any English. And I happened to be the only person on the tour that spoke Italian. So, I kind of got a private tour, and he was really cool, and he pointed out every little thing about the Moto Guzzis, from the first bike in 1918 through all the race bikes, all the production bikes, and stuff that I didn't know or hadn't heard about. There were a lot of bikes, you know. Guzzi really tried, you know, everything. They were, you know, inventors as much as they were motorcycle makers. Military bikes. They made a three-wheeled bike that had tracks on it, like a tank that you could remove and turn back into a regular motorcycle. You know, it was, they had a motorcycle that had like skis on it that the Finland police used, and you could put your feet, take them off the pegs and put them down under these skis and push down, and you had like a snowmobile. Problem was, when you put your feet on the skis, your feet weren't on the brakes, and there weren't any front brakes at the time. So they also had to invent this, like, geared, notchy brake system for the front wheel. They were doing, you know, liquid-cooled engines years before there was a production liquid-cooled engine. They were doing turbochargers. They were trying out, you know, different numbers of cylinders. And they were just a really innovative company in their day. And a lot of the technology that we have that we consider standard stuff, they made it years before anyone had it. And some of the stuff, they made it and then they threw it away because it just didn't work out right. So yeah, it was a very cool experience. And then after the museum, they shuttle you down into the gift shop. And everyone goes crazy. And I got to see the first kind of V7, which is the bike that mine's modeled after, and the V8 8-cylinder race bike, which is, you know, priceless. And that was it. And then we drove back home, but we went up top to another town along a beautiful road, and all along Lake Como, man. Amazing motorcycle roads. All you did was see bikes, people on the bikes, and every kind of bike. Japanese bikes, Italian bikes, Ducatis, Moto Guzzis, a lot of BMWs, Harleys, and like cool Harley dudes. There's like, you get these guys, Italians, dressed up in their coolest Harley gear and their vests and the patches and their big ass Harley Davidsons, and then they pull over. And then they stopped for gelato. So it's just like these two big biker guys just sitting there licking their gelato, eating their ice cream cones. You know, doesn't matter how tough you are, how tough you look. Once you sit down and start eating an ice cream cone, kind of takes the mystery out of things. There was one guy that had a dog, like a Yorkie Terrier named Capo, that he'd had a carrier, dog carrier. And it was like it was custom made almost for his Harley. And it had the doggles and a little helmet. The talk of the little town we were staying in. I met a guy named Pasquale on his 2011 Bellagio, Moto Guzzi Bellagio. And he was cool, and we just sat, and I said, oh, is this your bike? And we started talking, and just everyone was just really cool. And, hey, sit on my bike. Take a picture with sit on my bike. Another gentleman that had an old Moto Guzzi, he was the original owner, was just talking to me about his bike and where he likes to ride. And he was just, you know, about his day. Tired. That was his day-to-day transportation. And the Italians, it's great. They really do. They use their... What's going on? Welcome back to New York City. What are you doing? Now I'm back here. This mess. People in this place don't know how to drive. When there are motorcycles and other people on bicycles, it just becomes pretty annoying.
Hold your breath. Make a wish. Count to three.
Come with me, and you'll be in a world of pure imagination. Take a look, and you'll see into your imagination. We'll begin with a spin, traveling in the world of my creation. What we'll see will defy explanation. If you want to view paradise, simply look around and view it. Anything you want to do it. Want to change the world. There's nothing to it.